My parents wanted me to go to Kenya Medical Technical, whatever school, I can't remember, KMTC, whatever that means. Why? Because I had failed to get an opportunity to go to their university. And for them, they thought that having a course of that nature, you know, something to do with medicine, something to do with medical, whatever, has a potential for giving me employment as compared to any other thing at that point in time. And I think they were being encouraged by the fact that my brother was doing medicine at the university. I have never been so against a thought, against an idea, like I was against that. And I was being misunderstood all along as they wanted me to do all that stuff. I was a gifted guy. I mean, so much gifted with words. But the only thing that they saw was what was in the starter school. I want us to discuss continuously, even as we go on with these episodes, what do you do as a visionary when you're misunderstood by your friends and by your loved ones? Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
I knew I could write. My parents knew I could write. My teachers in primary school knew I could write. They saw what I was able to do. They saw what I was doing. And the problem is that at that moment in time, the starter school was not supportive of guys like me who were gifted in the arts in terms of writing and so on. And I had to go through high school with no bias towards writing. I had to go through high school to look for something that, you know, a combination of courses that is going to give me one of those things that the starter school was always offering and is still offering even as we speak today. Lawyer, engineer, doctor, pharmacist, and all those things. But writer? Are you kidding me? What are you talking about? Even myself, by the way, I did not even think that there is life in the arts, that there is life in, you know, love of words, love of reading, and love of writing, and thinking inside of your mind and coming up with characters and building them and creating books. I did not even think that there is life in there. It's only coming, you know, the past several, maybe 15 or so years that realization has been coming, and it's still increasingly evolving. And like I said in the previous episodes, the same thing is happening not just to me, it is happening around the world, where we have come to notice that the answer to life is not one. It is not being a lawyer, not being a pharmacist, not being an engineer, not being a doctor, not being a nurse, not being all those things that are always fixed and technical. The answers are not a silver bullet in life. And I think the answer is found in people's spirits and people's hearts. People who are unique and people who are different in their own unique and gifted ways. And there is a place for everyone who is unique and who is gifted. And that is just about everyone. But the problem is our templates of life are steeped into the status quo. The status quo dictates the way things are supposed to go. But a visionary rises up and sees, I need to pursue this. I feel led to pursue this. I feel in my spirit and in my heart so in love and so passionate about this. But it goes against the status quo. It goes against what everyone else wants to happen. And there is a misunderstanding that is created right then and there. When people, friends and loved ones see you walking to a different drumbeat, they consider you an outcast. They consider you a poser. They consider you prideful. They consider you different. And they treat you as much. They isolate you. They laugh at you. You know, they think that you are becoming too much. Maybe you're becoming rude and insolent and all those things. And there is a misunderstanding between the person who has a vision and a purpose and a passion and the people who are around them who want that person to follow the status quo. Perchance that is you. Perchance you've gone through life and at one point in time you've been forced, something has been forced into your throat. You've been forced to swallow some things like we used to be forced to swallow Scott's emulsion as kids. That thing that used to taste so weird but were being forced to. Maybe that's the same thing that has happened to you in terms of your career, in terms of your purpose in life, in terms of that flickering spark that is within you. It has been dulled and dimmed, but you've been forced to do some other things because you are misunderstood in what you stood for, misunderstood in what you're passionate about, misunderstood in what you wanted to bring to the fore in this life. You are so much in love with agriculture, but they wanted you to be working in an office. I mean, they can't fathom you with gumboots and, you know, with a hoe and all those things following after cows. That's where your passion is. And they're thinking that this guy is supposed to be working towards going into the office. I mean, this guy is not supposed to be a linguist. He's so much good with words and with languages. He's so in love with languages. But where is the market for languages? That's the thought of the status quo. But thankfully, ladies and gentlemen, that is changing today. Today's society is embracing increasingly that there is a place for the unique guys. There is a place for people with vision. There is a place for the DJ, as there is a place for the dancer. There is a place for the artist and the author, as there is a place for the doctor and the lawyer. And that's where life is going towards. Some years back, I think in maybe in 2003, somewhere around there, I made a prediction that the next revolution that is coming to this world, you see, we've come from the Stone Age, we've gone to the Agrarian Revolution, we've gone to the Industrial Age, and then we've come to the Knowledge Worker, the Information Age. But I'm telling you, even as right now I speak, they're saying that it's the age of the mind, the age of the context. But let me tell you, the age that is coming is the age of the heart, the age of purpose, where the designer and the doctor have a place, where the dancer and the DJ and all these weird people, we call them weird, these people make hairs and people do massages. There is an age where everyone and their purpose will be prevalent, will be relevant in society, thankfully. So what do? As a visionary, if you are one of those guys that are being misunderstood, we've been saying that the first thing you need to do to realize is that this thing did not come from the universe, did not come from the blue. It came from God, your creator. And I could even go far to say that the reason as to why you are created is for that very passion that is within your spirit, within your heart. That's why you're breathing in and out. That's why you've been allowed to be alive. That's why you've been sent on the face of the earth. So you need to go back to God and talk to God and pray to God and let Him help you through. The second thing that we said you need to do when you are misunderstood by people is to go back to the vision and clarify it. Accept the misunderstanding. Accept the questions. And in your mind and in your spirit and in your notebook, answer those questions, not for the benefit of the people who have misunderstood you, but for your own benefit, to cement and fortify the vision and clarify the vision and clarify the purpose. It is for your own good, because people will want to see not the concept, they want to see the reality. So the reality is going to come as you continue believing in it. And now, I want us to see one more thing that you can be able to do. When you're misunderstood, there are things, I'm going to put this in quotes, there are people in our lives who are different from those ones who are close to us. Everyone has that uncle who accepts us, who sees, who gets us basically, who sees the way things, the way we see them, who are not so sold and so invested into our lives to such an extent that they are so jittery about what could go right, what could go wrong. But the uncle is maybe far removed from the payment of the school fees and so on, and so he can be objective. So the third thing that you need to do when you're misunderstood by your friends and by your loved ones and by your parents, talk to uncle. At times the misunderstanding can be so great, people have been known to be thrown out of families because of this. I kid you not. You could even go ahead and say marriages have been known to break because of this. However, God has given us uncles and aunties who not only are our fans, I mean, they are loving us in whatever thing that we appear to be in love with. They are okay with it. But they are also great bridges between those who are misunderstanding us and us. They are basically like intercessors. You know, God has put intercessors in our lives all over the place. I'm telling the truth. All over the place, there is an uncle that can talk to your father and talk to you, can put his hand on your father and his hand on your shoulders all at the same time. Or even an auntie that can do the same thing. You see, there are those guys that you can refer to them, you can go to them when there is a misunderstanding. Even sometimes it can be your mother putting your hands on your shoulder and the other hand on your father's shoulder and trying to bring you around. So it is good for you to try and look around for that person that understands you, that person that gets you, that person that sees your hustle, that person that sees your passion, and talk down to those ones who are trying to force you into one thing or another. Because this intercessor of sorts is your fan and also your friend and also your kith and your kin. So find such a one and talk to them. Pour your heart to them. You know, find those guys who can be your mentors, you know, friends and coaches. Good mentors will not shut down the things that you want to do. They will warn you of the impending dangers with them, and they will try to dissuade you, but they will not say that this way or the highway. No, they will give you advice that is needed. These are mentors, these are friends, these are coaches, these are counselors. They can be great at this, but they can also provide a bridge between those ones who are misunderstanding you and yourself. So you need to find such like guys in your own wisdom, in your own understanding, and sit down with them and you just get comfort from them, get support from them. The thing that we need a lot is emotional support, emotional counsel, emotional acceptance that is going to propel us farther than any other thing that we do needed. If you just knew you had one fan, let me tell you how visions normally work. So sometimes people normally buy into a vision once it's become a reality and it's there and it's working. But when you are in the conceptual stage of your vision, sometimes you just need one person to agree with you. So just one person to, even if they don't understand you, just one person to support you. And these are guys that I'm calling uncle. So look for those guys, talk to them, have lunch with them, pour out your spirit, to pour out your heart to them and listen to them advise you and talk to you. And I think in due course, all things are going to fall into place. So as a visionary, don't suffer alone. Find an uncle, find a mentor, find a friend, find a mama, find a daddy, and confide with them and see how it goes. Tomorrow, we're going to share one more thing. Until then, bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.